Hello friends and welcome back on my channel. My name is Alex and this is the second video from this project, PowerSaw. And in this video I'm gonna make the motor, the base, this table, the belt, the slider guide and the slider with the saw. And let's start. We'll start with the slider guide. So we'll have to open a sketch in the front plane. And here we'll have to make the next sketch. We'll select line. And we'll make a rectangle first. Now we'll have to dimension this. This line will have 525. From this line to this line will be 50 millimeters. And now we'll have to select circle command and we'll have to make a circle here. Select this circle and this line, select here make tangent. Do the same with this side and this side. Now use trim entities command to cut this and this part of the circle. Now with smart dimension we'll give a dimension from this point to this point and this will be 500. Now go to features, use extruded boss base command. And here put 20 millimeters and press OK. Now select this face, open a sketch, normal 2, and here we'll have to make a circle. Now select this edge and this circle and select here make concentric and let's give this circle a dimension, will be 30 millimeter in diameter. Now go to features, use extruded boss base and here we'll put 65 millimeters and press OK. Now select this face, open a sketch, normal 2, and here we'll have to make the next sketch. Select line and make this sketch. Now let's dimension this. Here will be 15 millimeters. From this point to this edge will be also 15. From this point to this edge will be 20. Okay, this will have 30 millimeters. From this line to this line will be 15 millimeters. Now select line, from line select center line and make a center line from the middle of this line to the middle of this one. And now select this center line and select here make horizontal. This sketch is fully defined. Now go to features, use extruded boss base command, select here reverse direction. And here we'll put 340 millimeters and press OK. Now right click on this part, go to appearance, select here body and from here select the color you want this part to be and press OK. Right click on this cylinder, go here to appearance, select here face and selecting this face and here make it just like this and press OK. Now this part is done, the slider guide, and now we'll have to make the motor. So we'll have to open a new part. Here we'll have to open a sketch in the front plane. Yes. And here make a center line first. And now with line we'll have to make the next sketch. Make a two center lines from this point. First one will be from this point to this point, and the next one to this point. Okay, now let's dimension this. This center line will have 80 millimeters. Now from this line to this line will be 144, select this line and this point and select here make midpoint. This line will have 30 millimeters, this one will have also 30. Now select this one and this one and select here make collinear. Now select this line and this line, select here make collinear and do the same with this one. Now we will give a dimension from this line to this line. Here will be 22 millimeters. And this line will have 12. Now go to features, use extruded boss base, and here we'll put 124 millimeters. Press OK. And now select this face, open a sketch. Actually, first select this face, open a select this face, open a sketch, normal 2, and here we have to make a center line and then make two circles. Select them and make them equal, and then select these two points and select here make vertical. And now let's dimension this one. We'll have the diameter of 12 millimeters. From this point to this point will be 100 millimeters. And from this center point to this edge will be 12 millimeters. And from this center point to this edge will be also 12. Now press OK and use mirror entities command and select these two circles. At mirror about, select this center line and press OK. Go to features, use extruded cut, and here select through all, or you can select up to next and press OK. Good, now select this face, open a sketch, normal 2, and here we'll have to make a center line. And then we'll have to make a circle. We'll have to dimension this. This will have 80 millimeters. And this circle will have 144 millimeters. Now go to features, use extruded boss base, and here we'll put 10 millimeters and that direction too we'll put 162. And press OK. Now select this face, open a sketch, normal tool, and here we have to make a circle. Select this circle and this edge, and select here, make concentric. Now give this circle the dimension of 25 millimeters in diameter. Press OK and go to features, use extruded boss base, and here we'll put 60 millimeters and press OK. Now right click on this part, go to appearance, select here body, and from here select the color you want this to be, press OK, right click on this, go to appearance, select boss extruded tree and give this the color . Now open a sketch on this face. Here we have to make a center line first. And then select line. And make something like this. Select this point and this edge. And select make coincident. Then select convert entities command. Then select this edge. And press OK. Now we'll have to dimension this, and from this line to this edge will be 182 millimeters. This line will have 90 millimeters, and from this line to the center line will be 45. Now with trim entities command, we'll cut this part of the circle in this one. And now we'll go to features, we'll use extruded boss base. Here we'll select reverse direction. And here we'll put 100 millimeters. Press OK. And now select this face, open a sketch, normal tool. And here we'll select convert entities command. And from here we'll select sketch 6 and press OK. Now go to features, use extruded cut, and here put 30 millimeters and press OK. This part is done, the motor. Now we'll have to make the slider. For this we'll have to open another part. Now we'll have to open a sketch in the front plane, and here we'll have to make the next sketch. Okay, now let's define this. Select these two, select here, make equal, do the same with these two, and with these two. Now with smart dimension, we'll give here the dimension of 20 millimeters. This one will have 120. And from this line to this line, will be 30 millimeters. And from this line to this line will be 350 millimeters. From this point to this line will be 175. Now go to features, use extruded boss base, select here mid plane. and here put 20 millimeters. Press OK. And now right click on this, go to appearance, select here boss extruded, and select here the color you want this to be. Press OK. Now select this face, open a sketch, normal 2, and here we'll have to make the next sketch. Select line, and we'll have to make this sketch. Now we have to dimension this. Here will be 30 millimeters. Now click on this line and drag it up. This line here will have 12.5 millimeters. This one will have also 12.5. From this point will be 15. From this line will be also 15. Now select this line and this edge. Select here, make collinear. And from this line to this edge will be 40 millimeters. Now select this line and this line. Select here, make collinear. And this line will have 20. And from this line to this line will be also 40. Okay. Now we'll have to make a center line. From the middle of this line till here, and with smart dimension will give a dimension from this point to this point, and this will be 7.5. Okay, and from this line to this edge will be 10 millimeters. Now select this point and this point, and select here, make vertical. Now go to features, use extruded boss base, and here select reverse direction, and put here 410 millimeters. And press OK. Nice. Now select this face, open a sketch, normal 2. And here we have to make a circle first. And we'll dimension this. We'll have the diameter of 12 millimeters. From this point to this edge will be 25. And now select this point and this point, and select here, make horizontal. Go to features, use extruded boss base command, and here put 90 millimeters. Nice. Now we'll have to make the blade here, the saw. For this we have to open a sketch in the front plane, normal 2, and here we have to make the next sketch. Select line, and make a line from there to this edge, and we give this line, from this line to this edge, the dimension 15 millimeters. Okay, and now select line again and make the next sketch. Nice, now we'll have to dimension this. This line here will have 2 millimeters. From this line to this point will be 8 millimeters. From this point to this line will be 10. Select this line and this line. Select here, make collinear, and the dimension from this line to this line will be 10 millimeters. This line will have the dimension of 7 millimeters. Now we'll use linear sketch pattern to multiply this teeth and select here, actually put here 30 and select this, all of these three lines and press OK. Now here we'll use trim entities command to cut this line and we'll make another one. And now we'll have to close this sketch with line. Now we have our blade. It's just a sketch. So now we'll go to features, use extruded boss base. Here at blind select mid plane. And here put 2 millimeters and press OK. And the blade is done. Right click on it, go to appearance, boss extruded 4, and here select the color. Do the same end for this. Go to appearance, select boss extruded 2 and make it red. Now the slider is done and we'll have to make the base, the table, and let's do this. For this we'll have to open another part. We'll have to open a sketch in the front plane and here we'll have to make the next sketch. Let's dimension this. Here will be 150 millimeters. From this point to this point will be 160. This line will have 35. Now select this line and this one and select here make equal. From this point to this point will be 80 millimeters. Now go here, select center point arc command and make an arc here. Now go to features, use extruded boss base command. Here put mid plane and here we'll make it 900 millimeters and select this. Now open a sketch on this face. Here we'll have to make a rectangle. and we'll have to dimension this from this line to this edge. Will be 50 millimeters. Here will be also 50. And here will be the same. Now go to Features, use Extruded Cut, select here up to next and press OK. Now select this face, open a sketch, normal 2, and here we'll have to make 4 small circles. Select them and make them equal. Select this point and this one, make them horizontal. These two, make them vertical. These two, make them horizontal. And these two, make them vertical. Now we'll give this one a dimension. Here will be 12 millimeters in diameter. And from this one to this one will be 120 millimeters. From this center point to this edge will be 40 millimeters. And to this edge will be 30 millimeters. And from this center point to this one will be 100 millimeters. Now go to Features, use Extruded Cut, and here put 20 millimeters. Press OK. Now open another sketch on this face. Here we'll have to make a rectangle. And now let's dimension this. Here will be 20 millimeters. From this line, this edge will be 50 millimeters. And this will have 56 millimeters. And from this edge to this line will be 250 millimeters. Now select line again and make here something like this. And let's dimension this. From this line here will have 70 millimeters. And from this line to this line will be 10 millimeters. Now select a center line and make it from the middle of this line to the middle of this line. Select this center line and select here make horizontal. Now we'll use trim entities command to cut this. And now we'll have to select this point and this one. Select make it vertical. Actually, what we can do is select smart dimension and from this line to this point will be 28 millimeters. Now go to Features, use the Extruded Boss Base command, and here we'll put 160 millimeters. And press OK. Now we'll have to open a sketch on this face. And here we'll have to make the next sketch. select line and make a triangle just like this. Not like this. Click on this line and delete it. Now come with line like this. And now let's dimension this. From this point to this edge will be 100 millimeters. And now go to features, extrude that cut, and select here up to next, and press OK. Okay. Now select this face, open a sketch, normal tool, and here we'll have to make a circle with the dimension of 30 millimeters in diameter, and from this center point to this edge will be 135 millimeters. And now we'll have to select this point and this center point and select here make vertical. Go to features, use extruded cut, and here select up to next and press OK. Nice. Now select this face again, open another sketch, normal tool, and here we'll have to make the next sketch. Select this line and this line, and select here make equal. Do the same with these two. Okay, now we'll have to dimension this. From this line to this line will be 20 millimeters. From this line to this line will be 170. From this line to this edge will be 54 millimeters. From this line to this edge will be 30 millimeters, and this line here will have 140 millimeters. Okay. From this line to this line will be 46 millimeters. Now go to features, press OK here, use extruded boss base command. And here we'll put 35 millimeters. Press OK. And now select this face, open a sketch. Here we'll have to make a circle with the diameter of 17 millimeters. And the dimension from this center point to this edge will be 70 millimeters. And then select this center point and this point and select here make vertical. Now go to features, use extruded cut, and here select up to next. Press OK. And now select this face, open another sketch, normal tool. And here we'll have to make the next sketch. Select line and make it just like this. Now let's dimension this. This line here will have 20 millimeters. This one will have 50. This one here 85. From this one to this edge will be 60 millimeters. Now press OK and go to features. Use extruded boss base command. Select here reverse direction. And here select up to surface. And select this face. And press OK. Now this base is done, this table is done. Right click on this, go to appearance, select here body, and from here select the color you want this to be, or you can go here to appearance and from metal select steel and drag this to the table and press OK. I think it's looking better like this. Now what we have to do is to save all of these parts. I will save this like base. Base one and press OK. Save all of them. And in the next video I'm gonna show you how to assemble them and how to make the belt, because to make the belt we have to assemble them first and then we'll have to make the belt. And thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video where I'm gonna assemble all of these parts and I'm gonna show you how to make the belt. Thank you and see you in the next one.